Hello students, today I am going to start with the new chapter in the partnership accounting. The chapter we will be dealing today is the last chapter as well as the easiest chapter in the partnership series, and the name of the chapter is Dissolution of Partnership Firm. Dissolution of Partnership Firm. Now, what do you mean by partnership? Partnership is an association of two or more person who will come together in order to share the profits of the business. Now, in partnership, already we have studied admission of a partner, retirement of a partner and death of a partner. Now, all these chapter, admission, retirement and death of a partner, will deal with construction of partnership business. Now, what do you mean by construction? That is making, forming and running of the partnership business. Now, this chapter deals with the destruction of partnership business. Now, destruction is nothing but discontinuation or closing down of the partnership business. Now, when I am telling, I told dissolution of partnership is the easiest chapter when you compare to the other chapters like admission, retirement and death. Now, why it is easiest? Now, dissolution deals with construction, that is closing down of the business or discontinuation of the business. But other chapters will deals with construction of the business. Construction means running the business of the partnership. Now, which one is easy when you compare? Running a business is easy or closing a business is easy? Because closing the business is easy. Why? Because it requires less time and less efforts. That is one reason why dissolution of partnership firm is easy. Second reason is, in the admission, retirement and death of a partner, you have different calculations, like you have new profit sharing ratio, gain ratio, sacrifice ratio, then treatment of goodwill, etc. But such calculations are not included in dissolution of partnership firm. So, dissolution of partnership is easiest as well as the last chapter in the partnership series. Partnership and dissolution of partnership firm. Now, both are different from each other. Dissolution of partnership is nothing but here what some partners will cut off their connection or terminate their connection with the partnership firm, but other partners will continue the business with the same name under a new agreement. Here in the dissolution of partnership, the connection between the existing partner will be terminated due to admission of a partner or due to retirement of a partner or due to death of a partner. What will happen? The connection between the partners will be terminated, and but the business will continue. Before going to dissolution of partnership firm, we should know what is dissolution of partnership. Now, these both are different from each other. Dissolution of partnership and dissolution of partnership firm is different from each other. Now, dissolution of partnership firm is nothing but here some or few of the partners will terminate their relationship or cut off their relationship with the partnership firm, but the other or remaining partners will continue the business. Here main thing you should remember is the partnership business will continue. Only the relationship between the partners will terminated. Only one or few members or few partners will terminate or cut up their connection with the partnership, but the rest or remaining partners will continue the business. That is called as dissolution of partnership. Now, example for dissolution of partnership are admission of a partner, retirement of a partner and death of a partner. Now, whenever new partner is admitted, it is called as admission of a partner. That time what will happen? The existing agreement will be dissolved and the new agreement will be formed, because there is changes in the profit and loss sharing ratio of the partners due to the admission of a new partner. Same way in the case of retirement also, when any one partner leaves the partnership business, the other will continue the business, but there should be a new agreement. Those are the example for dissolution of partnership. Now, what do you mean by dissolution of partnership firm? Dissolution of partnership firm is nothing but complete closing down of the partnership business. Complete closing down of the partnership business. Here, all the partners will terminate their connection or cut up their connection with the partnership, and the partnership business will come to an end. In simple term, you can say dissolution of partnership firm is nothing but discontinuation of the partnership business. So now, dissolution of partnership and dissolution of partnership are different from each other. In the dissolution of partnership, partners will cut off their connection, but the business will continue. Here, all the partners will cut off their business and no partner will be remain. So, the partnership business will come to an end. Now, let us discuss the differences between dissolution of partnership and dissolution of partnership firm. Now, dissolution of partnership is nothing but only the few partners will cut off their connection with the partnership business and the remaining partners will continue the business. Only there will be a change in the agreement, but the business will continue. But in the dissolution of partnership firm, what will happen? All the partners will cut off their connection and the partnership business will come to an end. Now, let us see the differences one by one. First one is termination of the business. Termination means whether the business will close or no. But dissolution of partnership, the business does not come to an end. It will continue. But in the dissolution of partnership firm, what will happen? The partnership business will come to an end, because dissolution of partnership is also called as discontinuation of partnership. So, business will come to an end. Second point is settlement of assets and liabilities. In dissolution of partnership firm, how the assets and liabilities are settled? Dissolution of partnership relates to admission, retirement of a partner. There, how you will settle the assets and liabilities? By preparing revaluation account. So, assets and liabilities are revalued, and later you will prepare the new balance sheet after the admission of a partner, as well as in the retirement, after the retirement of a partner, what will do? You will revalue the assets and liabilities, and at the end you will prepare the new balance sheet. But in the case of dissolution of partnership, you are closing your business. So, what you have to do with the assets and liabilities? Whatever assets are there, that the partner has to sell, and liabilities to be paid off. Assets in the business should be sold or realized, and liabilities should be paid off. So, you have to close the assets and liabilities account. How you have to close? Because you are closing the business, so you have to close the assets and liabilities account. Assets are sold and liabilities to be paid off by the partner. The next point is relationship, that is economic relationship. Now, in the dissolution of partnership, because the business will continue, the relationship between the partners also will continue. And in the dissolution of partnership firm, because the firm will comes to an end, so the relationship between the partners also comes to an end. Next one is closure of books. In the dissolution of partnership, whether we'll close the books of account? No. In the admission or retirement, whether the books are closed? No. It does not require closure of the books, does not require, because the business continues, so books of accounts also will continue. In the dissolution of partnership firm, because the business is terminated, so books of accounts are also should be closed. And the last point is court's intervention, whether court will interfere. Now, in the dissolution of partnership form, what will happen? The dissolution of partnership will be done by the mutual consent of the partners. So, court does not interfere. Court does not interfere under dissolution of partnership, because the dissolution of partnership is done with the mutual consent by all the partners. But in the dissolution of partnership form, there is one reason that the partner can be dissolved, partnership firm can be dissolved by the order of the court, by the order of the court. For example, if the partnership firm is indulging in illegal activities, during that time the court might interfere and they might inform the partners to close the business. So, in the dissolution of partnership firm, court does not interfere, because dissolution of partnership is done by the partners, and in the dissolution of partnership firm, court might interfere in case if the partnership firm indulge in any illegal activities. So, this is with the mutual consent of the partners, and this can be done by the court if the partnership firm is indulging in any illegal activities and so on. So, these are the various difference between the two aspects, that is dissolution of partnership and dissolution of partnership firm. Okay, the next topic, that is circumstances under which a firm is dissolved, means the partnership dissolution of partnership firm can be takes place in the following cases. There are 5 cases, that is nothing but circumstances or reasons for the dissolution of partnership firm. The first one is dissolution by agreement. Dissolution by agreement. Now, here the partnership business will be dissolved or discontinued with the mutual consent of all the partners. When all the partners come together and if they decide mutually in order to close the business, then it is called as what? Dissolution by agreement. But if all the partners agrees to dissolve, then it is called as dissolution by agreement. It is nothing but consent of all the partners, as well as contract between the partners. If the contract says that if the partnership should be dissolved after a certain period of time, then if they agree, then they can dissolve the partnership business. So, here all the partners will mutually agree in order to dissolve the business of the partnership. Second one is compulsory dissolution. The dissolution of partnership can be done compulsory in these following cases. When the partner become insolvent. Insolvency means what? The partner will not be in a position to pay the debts of the business. That is called as insolvency. Then incompetent. If the partners become incompetent, if it is not in a position to carry out the duties, responsibility, etc., then it is called as incompetency, as well as illegal. If any partner indulges in any illegal activity, that time the partnership firm will be dissolved compulsorily due to these 3 cases. One is due to insolvency of the partner, second one is illegal activities, and due to incompetence of the partners. Next one is on the happening of certain contingencies, that is nothing but on the closing down of the certain activities. If the partnership firm is started by the partner for a fixed term, for example 5 years, three partners came together to continue the business for 5 years. After the end of the 5 years, they will dissolve the business. That is after the end of the fixed period, the firm will be dissolved. Second one is if the partnership business is for the particular venture, it might be for construction of building. After the end of that particular project or particular venture, then the partnership firm will be dissolved. as well as death of a partner. In case if only two partners are there, if one partner dies, then those cases the partnership form will be dissolved. One is for the after the completion of a fixed period, then after the completion of a particular venture, and death of a partner. The next fourth point is dissolution by notice. Dissolution by notice is nothing but if any one partner give a notice to the other partners in writing by seeking his information for the dissolution of partnership firm, that is called as dissolution by notice. Here one partner will give the notice to the other partner in writing, and here other if other all partners agrees, then they can dissolve the partnership business. They can dissolve the partnership business. So fourth point is dissolution by notice. Dissolution by notice is nothing but one partner will give a notice to other partners in writing by seeking his intention for dissolution. He will mention in that notice why he want to discontinue the partnership business. Now here important thing, if other partners agrees for his reason, then they can close the business. And last point is dissolution by court. Now court will interfere in dissolving the partnership firm. Some of the cases court will interfere for dissolving the partnership business. Now which cases? One is insane. If the partner become insane, that is mentally ill. Mentally ill means if he is not in a position to act as a partner, that is to take up his duties and responsibilities. Second one is incapable of performing the duties and responsibilities. Then continuous losses. If the partnership firm incur a continuous losses, then that time court might interfere in dissolving that particular business. Next one is transfer of interest to other party. If any partner has transferred his interest to the outsider, that is third parties, third party means the person who is not the partner of that particular business, in such cases court might interfere. And breach of partnership agreement. If any partner has not following the partnership agreement, if they are going against the partnership agreement, in such cases the court might interfere to dissolve the partnership business. So court might interfere in these cases, in when the partner become insane, when the partner become incompetent to carry out or incapable of carry out his duties and responsibilities due to continuous losses of the partnership business and transfer of interest to the third parties, as well as breach of partnership agreement. So these are the various ways or reasons or circumstances under which a partnership firm is dissolved. Yes, the next topic is settlement of accounts under dissolution of partnership firm. When the partnership firm is dissolved and the business is closed, naturally there should be a settlement of books of accounts. That means even the books of accounts also will close. Now when there is a losses, how the losses will be treated? First, the losses should be paid out of the profits of the business. Then if that money is not sufficient, then the losses will be paid out of the capital of the partners. Then if capital is also not sufficient, then partners has to, because the liability of the partner is unlimited, so here the partners will sell their private assets and they have to make the payment for the losses. They have to bear the losses. The losses will be paid first out of the profits earned by the business. If this is not sufficient, then the losses will be paid out of the capital of the partners, capital contribution made by the partners. In case if the capital is also not enough, then the partners has to pay from their personal assets or private asset, because in the partnership form the liability of the partner is unlimited. So they need to sell their personal assets and they have to bear the losses. Second one is application of assets. Application of assets is nothing but how the assets are utilized in the business, because when the partnership firm is dissolved, the partner has to dispose all the assets and they have to meet their liabilities, they have to make the payment. Now whatever assets are available in the business, the firm has to dispose, means they need to sell the assets, and whatever money they will get by selling the asset, that money they should utilize for making the payment to outsiders, that is to meet their liabilities, to meet their liabilities. Now the assets are applied to pay the debts to the outsider, to meet their liabilities, to make the payment to the outsiders like creditors, bills payable, bank loan, etc. Then advance of partners. If any partner has advanced money in the form of loan to the business, then that money should be given back to the partner. Any amount, if the partner has advanced to the partnership business in the form of loans, then the firm has to give back the money to the concerned partner who has advanced money to the partnership firm. Then capital, to pay the capital of the business, the whatever capital contributed by the business by the partners to the business should be given back by selling the assets of the business. And lastly, if any money remains after paying the debts, after giving the advances to the partner and after giving the capitals of the partner, still money remains, then that money should be divided among the partners according to their profit and loss sharing ratio. So when the firm is closed, even you need to close the books of accounts, that is you have to close all the assets account as well as liabilities account. So firm should realize the asset, dispose all the asset, because your business is closed, there is no use of any assets. So assets should be sold, and whatever money they will receive by selling the asset, that money is utilized to pay the debts of the outsiders. It might be bills payable, creditors, bank loan, etc. Then after that, if any partner has given advance money to the business in the form of loan, etc., that money should be given back to the partners, and later capital should be returned back, paid back to the partners. Still money remains, then that money should be divided among the partners according to their profit and loss sharing ratio. The next topic is settlement of firm's debts and partners' private debts. Under dissolution of partnership firm, how to settle the debts of the firm as well as how to settle the partners' debts. Now, first, the assets of the firm is used. As I told in the beginning, whenever firm is dissolved, the assets of the firm are realized, and whatever money you will collect by selling the asset, that money the partner has to utilize to pay the debts of the firm. So first they need to pay the debts of the firm. It might be creditors' money, it might be bills payable, it might be bank overdraft or bank's loan. Any outsider money is there, first that money should be settled by utilizing the assets money, that by selling the asset. Then whatever money remains after paying the debts of the outsiders, that money should be distributed among the partners according to their profit and loss sharing ratio. So whatever money the partners will get, then that money they can utilize to pay their private debts of the partners. Now, first, whatever money the firm will get by selling the asset, that money first utilized to pay the firm's debts, that is a liability of the firm, outsiders' money. Then whatever money remains, it will be given to the partners according to their profit and loss sharing ratio, and whatever money partners will get, they can utilize to pay their personal debts. Second one is the private property of a partner. Now, under partnership firm, the liability of a partner is unlimited. Now, the private property, by selling the private property of a partner, the partner can utilize that money first to pay his private debts. He can pay his debts by selling his private properties. And in case if the firm's assets are not sufficient to pay the liabilities, of the firm, that time the partner has to contribute money by selling his private assets, because the liability of the partner is unlimited. So in that case, he has to sell his private assets and he has to make the payment to the firm, that is to make the liabilities or to contribute in the losses of the firm. So, private property is utilized by a partner. First, he has to utilize to pay his private debts or personal debts to others, and in case if the firm doesn't have a sufficient fund to pay the liabilities, then the partner has to contribute money in paying the firm's debts, because the liability of the partner is unlimited. The next topic is dissolution account. So, dissolution of partnership firm means what? You are closing the business of the partnership. So, when you close the business of the partnership firm, you need to close the books of accounts. Now, whenever you start a business, you will start with capital, then you will invest money in the assets by buying the assets, machinery, plant, land, building, furniture, motor vehicles, etc. Then there might be liabilities, like you might have borrowed money from bank, as well as you might have taken money from outsiders, etc. There are assets as well as liabilities. Now, whenever you are closing the business, what the partner has to do? First, they have to list out the various assets as well as various liabilities of their business. Then, whatever assets are there, the partner has to dispose all the assets. Dispose means nothing but the partner has to sell all the assets, because there is no use of keeping the asset because they are closing the business. So, whatever assets are there, it might be land, it might be building, it might be furniture, machinery, vehicles, etc. They need to sell, and by selling that asset, they will collect money, they will get money. Whatever money they will receive by selling the asset, that money they have to utilize to pay the liabilities, to make the payment of the liabilities. So, first, assets should be realized, second, liability should be paid off. Then, after paying the liability, if any surplus money remains, then that money should be distributed among the partners according to their profit and loss sharing ratio. Now, in the dissolution of partnership also, you need to prepare the accounts. Now, in the admission of retirement, you used to prepare which account? Revaluation account, partners capital account, cash or bank account, goodwill account, and at the end you need to prepare balance sheet. Now, in the dissolution of partnership also, you need to prepare 3 accounts. How many accounts you have to prepare? 3 accounts. First one is realization account. First account is realization account. And second one is partners capital account. Second account is partners capital accounts. And third one is cash or bank account. Cash or bank account. Cash or bank account. Now, in the admission and retirement, the first account used to prepare was revalue account, because there, after the admission or retirement of a partner, there may, the values of assets and liabilities to change due to the admission as well as retirement of a partner. In order to record the revalues of assets and liabilities, in the admission and retirement used to prepare revaluation account. But in dissolution of partnership firm, you have to prepare realization account, because you are closing the business, so the books of accounts also should be closed. Means you are selling all the assets as well as you are making all the payments. So in order to record those items, you have to prepare realization account. So realization account is an account prepared at the time of dissolution of partnership firm in order to record assets realized and liabilities paid, and to find out profit or loss on sale of assets and payment of liabilities. So realization account is prepared for two reasons. One is to record all the assets realized and liabilities paid, and second one is in order to find out profit or loss on sale of assets and payment of liabilities. Now, in the realization account, you will get profit or loss. If credit side of realization account is more than the debit side, then it is profit. If debit side is more than the credit side, then it is loss. So in the realization account, you will find out profit or loss by recording all the assets and liabilities, that is assets realized as well as payment of liabilities. Now, whatever profit or loss you will get, that profit or loss should be distributed among the partners, should be distributed among the partners according to their profit and loss sharing ratio. So the realization account balance is transferred to the next account, that is nothing but partners capital account. Then you will prepare partners capital account. Partners capital account is same like under admission and retirement. So you will begin with opening balance, that is capital, then you will record reserve or reserve fund, then you will record the share in the undistributed loss or profit, as well as you will record the realization account profit or loss. Then any information regarding the partners you will record under partners capital, like assets taken over as well as liabilities taken over. Everything you will record partners capital account, all the information relating to the partners. Then at the end, the partners capital account is balanced, and whatever balance will get, it should be transferred to the next account. Partners capital account balance is transferred to cash or bank account. Now, why you are not transferring the partners capital account balance or two balance carried on? Why you are not writing here? Because you are closing the business, we have to close the partners capital account. So partners capital account is closed settled by transferring their money to cash or bank account. At the end, you will prepare cash or bank account in order to record all the cash and bank balances. That is nothing but how much cash is received and how much cash is paid. So at the end, cash or bank account should be tally. Then only your problem is correct. So cash or bank account is prepared at the end in order to record all the cash or bank transaction, that is cash receipts and cash payments, and at the end of cash or bank account should be tally. Now you might have one question here, why there is no balance sheet in the admission and retirement? At the end you used to prepare balance sheet, but in the dissolution of partnership firm we are not going to prepare the balance sheet. The reason is because you are closing the business, all the assets and liabilities accounts are also closed, correct? In the realization account, what you are doing, you are selling all the assets and you are making all the payment. So there is no assets, there is no liabilities in the business, because whatever assets are there, it will be realized, and whatever liabilities are there, it should be paid off. So there is no liabilities and assets in the business. So no preparing balance sheet at the end. So so which account will be the last, cash or bank account? So these are the three accounts are prepared under dissolution of partnership firm. That is, first one is realization account, second one is partners capital account, and third one is cash or bank account. So in this session we have studied about dissolution of partnership firm. You have studied the meaning of dissolution of partnership as well as meaning of dissolution of partnership firm. Then we have studied the differences between two, that is dissolution of partnership and dissolution of partnership firm. Then we have studied the circumstances or reasons for the dissolution of partnership firm, and then we have studied settlement of account, how the books of accounts are settled. Then we have studied settlement of firm's debts and partners' private debts. Then finally we have studied which are the accounts to be prepared under dissolution of partnership firm. Next session we will study in detail all these three accounts, how to prepare these three accounts with format.